And when it paralyzes you, you can't move. Cuando te paraliza, no te puedes mover hacia adelante. Fear will come and tell you that you can't. El miedo viene y te dice que no puedes. El miedo viene y te dice, o el temor viene y te dice que no eres lo suficiente, no estás educado lo suficiente. It tells you that you're not educated enough to be able to do what God called you to do. Para poder hacer lo que Dios te ha encomendado que hagas, mi hermano. El miedo viene, aleluya, a atacar nuestra vida. Fear comes and it paralyzes us as Christians, and we're immovable. We can't move and do what God called us to do or advance the kingdom of God because we're so afraid. A veces no podemos movernos y movilizarnos y hacer lo que Dios nos ha encomendado hacer, mi hermano, porque tenemos miedo. But there's a group that has sprung out that is not scared, that is not afraid, that is the LGBT or whatever you call them. They're not scared. They're moving. And they're gaining ground, aleluya. Aquel grupo nuevo, aleluya, de homosexuales y lesbianas, ellos no tienen miedo. Ellos están avanzando y ellos están agarrando terreno. And the church is being like the army of the Lord when Goliath would come up. They're backed out and they're hiding. Se está escondiendo el pueblo de Dios. But I'm here to tell you, aleluya, my God, that in 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 7, 2 de Timoteo capítulo 1, versículo 7, the word of God says, I have not given you the spirit of fear, but a power of love and of a sound mind. Hallelujah. 2 de Timoteo capítulo 1, 7 dice, porque no les he dado el espíritu de temor, sino de poder, o el espíritu de cobardía, dice, de poder, de amor y de dominio propio. Can I get an amen somebody? God did not put fear in you. Dios no puso el miedo o el temor dentro de ti. That's the enemy's job. Ese es el trabajo del enemigo. For God has, can you put it up there, 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7, 2 Timoteo 1 verse 7. God has not given us the spirit of fear, but a power of love and of a sound mind. Can you read it with me? Let us read it all together. Vamos a leerlo todos juntos en inglés. I'll put it in English first. Aleluya. It says, for, come on. One, two, three. Let's go.
God has not given us the spirit of fearfulness, but by the power of love and sound judgment.
He hasn't given you a spirit of fear. No te ha dado un espíritu de temor, un espíritu de cobardía. Pero de poder, de amor, de dominio propio. Power, love, sound mind. Power, love, sound mind. Say it with me. Power, love, sound mind. Power, love, sound mind. Hallelujah. God's people were tormented by fear. El pueblo de Dios estaba atormentado por ese miedo. And it seems like everyone or everywhere, fear was coming in. Fear came into the disciples. El temor, el miedo vino sobre los discípulos. These disciples were walking with Jesus and still were afraid. Estos discípulos caminaban con Jesús, mi hermano, y todavía tenían miedo. They were scared, not knowing that they had Jesus on their side. They were scared constantly of storms. Tenían miedo de las tormentas. They were scared, aleluya, of different things in their life. Tenían miedo de diferentes cosas en su vida.
Yes, Lord.
Can I get an amen?
Amen.
When Jesus told them to cross to the other side, Jesús les dijo, vayan hacia el otro lado. They were scared when the storm arose, aleluya, and they were in the boat. Tenían miedo cuando vino la tormenta y empezó a sacudir ese barco. The storm came and started shaking that boat. They were scared. Scared to the point that when they saw Jesus, they thought it was a ghost.
Glory.
Not knowing that he was the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Tenían miedo, aleluya, cuando vieron a Jesús y pensaban que era un fantasma. Aleluya. They were so scared. Aleluya. Not knowing that they had the Almighty, all-powerful God with them. Sin saber que tenían al Todopoderoso ahí con ellos, aleluya. Can I get an amen, somebody?
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus, hallelujah, for being who you are. The people of God, hallelujah, when the army of the Lord, el ejército del Señor, mi hermano, hallelujah, they were scared. They were scared of this Goliath. The tape measure read 9 feet 6 inches. La cinta de medir medía 9 pies 6 pulgadas cuando Goliath, when Goliath stood up. And they were scared. Tenían miedo. They were scared. And Goliath kept on. The Bible says that he would come in day and night. Day and night. La Biblia dice que Goliath salía día y noche, tormentando al pueblo de Dios. How long are you going to let the enemy torment you? How long are you going to let the enemy come in and bring fear? ¿Qué tanto vas a dejar? ¿Hasta cuándo vas a dejar que este diablo, este enemigo, venga y te tormente día tras día, noche tras noche? Aleluya. We need some David to rise up and say, I ain't going to be afraid. Necesitamos un David que se levante y diga, yo no voy a tener miedo, but I'm going to stand up, aleluya. I refuse to be afraid. Aleluya. I'm something that has already been defeated. Yo rehuso ser derrotado o tener miedo de algo que ya fue derrotado. Aleluya. My God.
Yes, Lord.
See, when you approach a giant, you have to approach him with victory already in mind. Did you hear me? Cuando tú vas a un, aleluya, vas a un gigante, tú tienes que ir hacia él con tu mentalidad de decir, ya soy campeón, ya soy victorioso, aleluya. I'm coming out on top. Yo voy a seguir y yo voy a salir adelante. Why? Aleluya. Because the one who saved me gave me the victory already, aleluya. Aquel que me salvó ya me dio la victoria. Can I get an amen, somebody? My God, hallelujah. Woo, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Fear creeps in to the people. And fear paralyzes you, like I said. You must say, Pastor, you said that word already. But I'm here to tell you, the reason that I keep on saying this word is because many of you were, after this morning, you were paralyzed. And you were not moving for God. Muchos de ustedes estaban paralizados y no se movían por Dios. But after this day, after this morning, I will no longer, I will say, look at your neighbor, tell them, I will no longer be afraid. See, when Moses sent the 12 spies to go spy the promised land, cuando Moisés mandó a los 12 espías a espiar la tierra prometida, listen, two of them came back with a good report. Dos de ellos vinieron con un reporte bueno. They said, man, the land is good. There's milk and honey. There's giants, but we can handle those giants. Hallelujah. But listen to what we see. They didn't go on in there worrying about the lions. They were in there to grab what was inside that promised land. Did you hear me? Oh, Jesus. El pueblo de Dios, aleluya, déjame decirte que cuando estos dos espías trajeron ese reporte bueno, ellos no fueron con la mirada en los gigantes, ellos fueron con la mirada en lo que estaba dentro de la tierra prometida, que era la leche, que era la miel, que eran los racimos de uva. They brought the grapevines, aleluya, and they brought them with them and said, look, this stuff is good. Eso está bueno. But 10 of them came back with what the Bible calls a bad report. 10 de ellos regresaron con lo que la Biblia dice, un reporte malo. And that bad report says, you know what, there's live giants over there. We didn't even look at the honey, at the trees, or how beautiful they were. Our eyes were on the giants. Los 10 espías, ¿sabes qué dijeron los 10 espías? Nuestros ojos estaban nomás en los gigantes. Nuestros ojos no estaban en la miel, en la leche, en las uvas. No estaba nada de eso. Nuestros ojos estaban en los gigantes. And their report to the people of God, el reporte de ellos al pueblo, you know what it was? This is what it was. They said, we are like grasshoppers before their eyes.
Amen.
Digo, somos como chapulines ante ellos. There's a lot of Christians that have a grasshopper mentality. Hay mucho cristiano que tiene una mentalidad de chapulín, bien pequeña, not knowing that the one that saved you is greater than any giant that you'll ever face. Sin saber que aquel que te salvó es más grande que cualquier gigante que tú te enfrentes. Hallelujah. I will not be defined by what the enemy says I am. I'm going to be defined by what God says I am and who God says I am. Ya no seré definido, mi hermano, por lo que dice el enemigo, sino por lo que dice Dios en su palabra. And isn't it amazing, maravilloso, mi hermano, that the 10 that brought the bad report, los 10 que trajeron el mal reporte, paralyzed a whole nation for 40 years. Esos que trajeron el mal reporte, de esos 10 que trajeron el mal reporte, ¿sabe qué, mi hermano? Paralizaron a toda una nación por 40 años. You see what fear does? Fear paralyzes you for years. El miedo, mi hermano, te paraliza por años. I believe they could have crossed easily. Ellos pudieran haber cruzado, but because they were afraid, they didn't cross. And you know what? There was tragedy, because the Bible says that a whole generation was lost in the wilderness. Había una tragedia tremenda, mi hermano. ¿Sabe por qué? Porque de acuerdo a la Biblia nos dice que toda una generación se perdió en el desierto. ¿Por qué? Por miedo. Fear. Loss. You cannot afford to lose a generation in your family because of fear. Did you hear me? Tú no puedes. No puedes. Tú no puedes perder una generación de tu familia por miedo. Did you hear me? Because God did not give you fear. God gave you love. God gave you power. God gave you a sound mind. Dios te dio temor. Dios te dio, aleluya, amor. Dios te dio poder. Dios te dio, aleluya, una mentalidad sana. You can't afford to lose your child. You can't afford to lose your son or your daughter. No puedes perder, mi hermano, permitir que tú puedas perder, aleluya, un hijo o una hija. Por miedo.
Aleluya.
So with this, I want to give you something real quick. Fear. The fear that people have. See, fear keeps people from doing stuff. El temor, mi hermano, causa que la gente no haga algo. Listen, number one, fear disregards God's plan. El temor, mi hermano, te hace que descuides el plan de Dios. El temor hace que descuides el plan de Dios. Fear disregards God's plan. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Because I believe that when God speaks and gives you a word, you gotta be obedient to that word. Cuando Dios habla y te da una palabra, tú tienes que ser obediente a esa palabra. Can I get an amen? So listen, go with me to Deuteronomy chapter 1, verse 19 through 21. I'm going to try to do this quickly, so if you can help me. Los que tienen español, me siguen en español, por favor. En Deuteronomio capítulo 1, versículo 19 al 21. When you have it, you may say amen. Deuteronomy chapter 1, verse 19 to 21. Listen to what it says. Mira lo que dice. Then as the Lord our God commanded us, we set out for Horeb and went towards the hill country of the Amorites through all that vast and dreadful wilderness that you have seen. And so we reached Kadesh Barnea. Verse 20 said, then I said to you, you have reached the hill country of the Amorites, which the Lord our God is giving us. Listen to verse 21. See, the Lord your God has given you the land. Go up and take possession of it, as the Lord and the God of your ancestors told you. Do not be afraid.
Hallelujah.
Do not fear.
Hallelujah.
Do not be discouraged.
Hallelujah.
I've already gave you the land. Just go take it.
Hallelujah.
No tengas miedo. Dice, he aquí el Señor que te ha dado la tierra para poseer. Ve y tómala. No tengas miedo y no te desanimes. ¿Quién quiere animar? God laid out everything for them and he said, go get it. Dios lo puso todo delante de ellos y dijo, ve a agarrarlo. Jesus. God said, look, I laid all this thing for you. In other words, God said, listen, I got all these presents here for you. All you got to do is go get them. They're yours. Dios dice, en otras palabras, Dios dice, mira, todos estos regalos te los he dado a ti. Ahora nomás tienes que ir a agarrarlos. There's promises that you don't have because you haven't gotten up to get them.
Come on now.
Hay promesas que están ahí y tú no las has obtenido porque tú no te has levantado a obtenerlas o a ganarlas. Why? Because fear paralyzed you. And you can't move. El miedo, mi hermano, el temor ha venido, te paralizó, no te puedes mover. And therefore, those promises, that gift, that which you were asking God for, is there, but you can't get it because you are afraid. Aquello que por lo cual tú le estabas orando a Dios, mi hermano, Dios ya te lo dio, pero no puedes recibirlo porque tienes miedo. Can I get an amen? Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
We made it through this dusty, listen, he said, we made it through this wilderness. In other words, he said, the worst, we already went through it.
Hallelujah.
Right? He said, now we're coming into our future, our dreams, our promises. We're about to enter this thing that God gave us. Decía, dice la palabra de Dios, dice, este desierto feo, dice, ya no pasamos, otra palabra, ya pasamos lo peor. Ahora enfrente de nosotros está una tierra prometida. Not only is the promised land there, no solamente está la tierra prometida ahí, pero Dios, but God told us to go grab it. If your father tells you to go do something, what you gonna do? Si tu padre te dice que hagas algo, tenemos que ir a hacerlo. So your father said, listen, I already laid it out before you. All you gotta do is take it. Look at the neighbor and tell him, you just gotta take it. It's yours, it's tuyo. God said, listen, I got you out of Egypt, te saqué de Egipto, with all the plagues that I sent, todas las plagas que mandé. I took care of Pharaoh and his army. Me encargué de Faraón y su ejército. I opened up the Red Sea for you. Abrí el Mar Rojo para ti so that you can walk on dry ground. During the night, I did a pillar of fire, hallelujah. Un pilar de lumbre, dice, por a través de la noche. And then through the day, there was a cloud, a beautiful cloud, that just brought coolness to your day. Una nube que trajo un fresco sobre tu vida a través del día. And then when you were hungry, I caused manna to fall down from heaven. Hallelujah. Cuando tenías hambre, hice que cayera maná del cielo. My God, hallelujah. Is anybody enjoying this word today? So God said, throughout your worst.
Hallelujah.
Throughout that dry and nasty wilderness, I provided for you. A través de ese desierto feo, seco, horrible que pasaste, dice Dios, ahí estaba yo. Te di maná del cielo. I gave you water from a rock. Te di agua de una roca. My God, hallelujah. So God said, while you were going through your worst, I was at my best. Oh my God. Cuando tú estabas pasando por lo peor, dice el Señor, yo te estaba dando lo mejor. Hallelujah. My God. Hallelujah. You ain't never seen, hallelujah, no meal like I give from heaven. Tú no has visto comida como la que yo doy del cielo. My God. Hallelujah. I don't know who prepared the meal for Elisha when he was in the brook. Yo no sé quién le preparó la comida a Elías cuando estaba en el arroyo. But it was good. It was good. It was not fattening. It did not have any kind of those other calories. But it was all coming down from heaven. Hallelujah. Venía esta comida del cielo. I don't know who I'm talking to today, but you need to stop complaining about your worst day and start rejoicing, because that's when he gives you his best. Hallelujah. Deja de quejarte de tu pasado, de tu peor, porque Dios te va a dar lo mejor. So God said, listen, I took care of you when you were going through the listen. God said, I took care of you even when you complained to me. Aún cuando te quejaste, dijo el Señor, como quiera te di de comer.
Aleluya.
Como quiera, hice que se parara el sol. See, when you got mad at me, I didn't get mad at you. Cuando tú te enojaste conmigo, dice el Señor, yo no me enojé contigo. Because can you imagine had I got mad at you? ¿Te imaginas si Dios se hubiera enojado con el pueblo de Dios? At one point he got mad and he was about to strike everybody.
Yes, he was.
En un tiempo sí, se enojó y quería destruir a todo el pueblo.
Glory.
Aleluya.
He was so upset. Listen, before he told Moses, Moses, go tell Pharaoh to let my people go. Dios le dijo a Moisés, Moisés, quiero que vayas y le digas a Faraón que suelte a mi pueblo. But when he got upset, listen to you, read your Bible. Lee su Biblia cuando se enojó. Cuando se enojó Dios con el pueblo de Dios porque no está. ¿Sabes qué dijo Dios? He goes up to Moses and goes, Moses, your people?
Come on now. Come on, bro.
Read your Bible.
Hallelujah.
Dios le dijo a Moisés, Moisés, tu pueblo? The one you brought up. And I can imagine Moses going, but I thought they were yours. Yeah, but right now they're yours because they're not listening to you. Your people, Moses? They don't listen to me.
Hallelujah.
How many of us, after God blesses us so many times, we still don't pay attention to it? ¿Cuántos de nosotros, después de que Dios nos bendice por mucho, no le ponemos atención a Dios? We still do our own thing. Todavía hacemos lo de nosotros. So fear disregards God's plan. In other words, it causes you to put God's plan aside and not really believe in it. Te causa, mi hermano, el temor te causa que no, que descuides el plan de Dios y que no le ponga mucha atención. ¿Cuánto dicen amén? Jesus, my God. Thank you, Lord. Number two, fear distorts God's plan. Distorts God. El temor, mi hermano, distorsiona el plan de Dios. Fear distorts God's plan. In other words, it distorts our view of what God has for us. Cuando el plan de Dios se nos da, mi hermano, viene el temor y distorsiona nuestra manera de ver el plan de Dios. And sometimes the way you see the plan of God is not the way God has designed for it for you. Y de la manera de la cual tú miras el plan de Dios sobre tu vida no es la manera que Dios a veces la tiene para ti. Pero el temor ha venido y distorsionó tu mente. It distorted your mind. So you begin to see things, aleluya, totally different. Can I get an amen, somebody?
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. God is good.
All the time.
Hallelujah. See, you see things totally different when fear comes in. Tú ves las cosas totalmente diferentes cuando el temor viene. Deuteronomy, same book, chapter 1, same chapter, verse 27 and 28, versículo 27 y 28, primera de, digo, Deuteronomy capítulo 1. Listen to what it says. Let me put on my other eyes. Hold up. Y'all ready? Verse 27 says, you grumble in your tents and said, the Lord hates us. Well, he brought us out of Egypt to deliver us into the hands of the Amorites to destroy us. Where can we go? It's a question. Our brothers have made our hearts melt in fear. They said the people are stronger and taller than we are. The cities are large with walls up to the sky. We even saw the Anakites there. Fear had distorted their sight, their mind. El temor distorsionó su mente, su vista. And when they should have seen, see, when you have a giant in front of you, you should always see it as an opportunity. My God. Cuando viene un gigante o cuando tú miras a un gigante enfrente de ti, siempre tienes que verlo como una oportunidad. Yes. An opportunity for what? An opportunity to show God's glory.
Aleluya.
Una oportunidad, mi hermano, de enseñar o mostrar la gloria de Dios. You know what Jesus did when he confronted an opportunity? When Lazarus was in the tomb, Jesus looked up to heaven and said, God, this is my opportunity. He said, this is for you to get the glory. This is so that everybody that is here can see that there's a living God. Aleluya. Cuando Jesús se enfrentó, aleluya, contra Lázaro que estaba muerto, Jesús miró hacia el cielo y dijo, Señor, es una oportunidad para que todo este pueblo vea que hay un Dios vivo y que tu gloria se muestre en la vida de esta persona. I believe that that if other family members that have dead people also would have came up to him, he would have brought them out of the tomb.
Yes, he would have. Yes.
But they only asked for Lazarus.
Amen.
Yo pienso, yo siento en mi corazón que si otra familia viniera y le dijera a Jesús en ese momento, mi tío, mi tía, mi mamá, mi papá se murió también, puede sacarlo. Él lo hubiera hecho, pero nomás pidieron por Lázaro. Entonces él nomás sacó a Lázaro para afuera. Lázaro fue afuera y salió. And it was an opportunity. See, death did not distort God's plan. Death does not distort Jesus' view or thought. El temor no distorsionó la mente de Cristo. No distorsionó la vista. Él sabía, la muerte, una oportunidad. Death is an opportunity. You know why? You know why Jesus was so confident? Because he knew that at the cross he was going to defeat it again. Él sabía que en la cruz iba a derrotar a la muerte una vez más. Can I get an amen, somebody? So fear comes in and it distorts God's plan for your life. El temor viene y distorsiona, mi hermano, el plan de Dios sobre tu vida. Number three, fear discourages God's people. El temor, mi hermano, desanima al pueblo de Dios. Many people are discouraged right now because of fear. Fear, el temor. Can I get an amen, somebody?
Amen.
Can I tell you something? Fear is, discouragement is contagious. El desánimo, mi hermano, es contagioso. If I have somebody here sitting down discouraged and he starts talking to somebody else, he can get that person discouraged. Si hay una persona que está aquí sentada y está desanimada, esa persona puede hablar con alguien más y la desanima también. Why? Because fear is contagious, and when you discourage, when one's discouraged, they can discourage another people. Cuando una persona se desaniman los demás. You remember the 10 spies? They were discouraged when they went in there. So they discouraged the whole nation. They desanimaron a toda una nación. And they said, let's just stay out here in the wilderness. It's a lot better. We just stay here. Nos quedamos aquí, aquí en el desierto. But I'm here to tell you today, do not get discouraged. No te desanimes. But instead, take courage. Don't get discouraged, but take courage. No te desanimes, sino que toma ánimo. Come on. Look at your neighbor and tell him, take courage. My God, hallelujah. God is here for you. And lastly, number four, fear disobeys God's principles. El temor te hace que desobedezcas los principios de Dios. Fear causes you to disobey God's principles. Fear is disobedience. Temor es desobediencia. Simple, plain and simple. Fear is disobedience. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Why? Because God said, go and take it. And the people did not go, so they disobeyed God. Dios le dijo, ve y toma la tierra. La gente no lo obedeció y no tomó la tierra. Eso es desobediencia. El temor, el miedo te hace que desobedezcas a Dios. God told Peter, come. Give him a commandment. Peter obeyed God. Peter walked out on the boat regardless of how the water looked. He walked out and he looked and he said, I'm coming out. I'm obedient. And he walked not on water. He walked on obedience. Pedro no caminó en la palabra. Pedro caminó en la obediencia cuando Jesús le dijo, ven, salte del barco. And when he stepped out into the water got hard because of the obedience. La agua se hizo dura, mi hermano, por la obediencia. And water was able to withhold Peter as he walked towards Jesus. La agua pudo sostener a Pedro cuando él iba caminando hacia Jesús. Can I get an amen? So there's many people in the church that are walking in disobedience because they're not paying attention to God's principles, the principios de Dios. God told you to get up and you're still down. Dios te dijo, levántate y todavía estás caído. God told you to speak and you're still quiet. Dios te dijo que hablen y tú todavía estás callado. God said, praise me and you don't want to praise him. Dios dice, alábame y tú no lo quieres alabar. I'm here to tell you that fear has caused you to be disobedient.
Yes.
El temor causado que tú seas desobediente. Dios dice, alábame, y no le alabas. God says, worship me. No feel like worshiping God today. No siento como alabar a Dios. I'm just in this so they can see me. No me voy a la iglesia para que me vean. God gives principles and God gives commands and God says law. And when we disobey, we're disobeying because we're operating out of fear. Estamos operando bajo un espíritu de temor. See, a lot of people don't trust God with their tithes and their offerings because they're operating on fear and not on faith. Mucha gente no da los diezmos y la ofrenda porque están operando bajo el temor y no en la fe. Los diablos en fear. Faith causes you to believe for the impossible. La fe te causa que creas por lo imposible. See, you can walk in fear the rest of your life and in disobedience. And disobedience, according to Scripture, says it's like witchcraft. As witchcraft. Dice la palabra de Dios que la desobediencia, mi hermano, viene y la compara como la brujería. So when God says, this is the day of salvation, or this is your day, rejoice. And when you choose not to rejoice, you're walking in disobedience. Dice, Señor, este es el día que he hecho. Gózate. Y si no te gozas, estás caminando en ¿qué? En desobediencia. So you can continue to walk in disobedience, or you can change everything and say, I'm going to walk in obedience, and I'm going to walk in faith. Voy a caminar en obediencia y voy a caminar en fe. And whatever you say, I'm going to do. Lo que tú me digas, yo lo voy a hacer. I'm not going to let fear paralyze me anymore. Do I have anybody in here that says, I'm not letting fear paralyze me anymore? Hay alguien aquí que diga, yo ya no voy a dejar que el temor me paralice, but I'm going to praise him anyway. Hallelujah. I'm going to praise him in my good day, and I'm going to praise him in my bad day. Yo me voy a alabar en la buena, yo me voy a alabar en la mala, because in my bad days, he's there. In my good days, he's there. En mi mala, ahí está. Y en las buenas, ahí está. He will provide for me anyhow, anyway. Él va a proveer para mí. He'll make a way in my desert. He'll make a way, hallelujah, in my wilderness. En mi desierto, él abre camino. En mi tribulación, él abre camino. My God. So, you can choose to walk in faith or choose to walk in fear. And he saw everybody.
One.
Y todos nos salimos del camino del Señor solamente por una persona. La cabeza del hogar se salió del camino y todos se salieron también.
So, I find myself coming back second time and it's hard.
Me veo que regreso otra vez a los caminos del Señor y es más duro. Dice, ¿qué? ¿Por qué está duro si no te estás muriendo ahora? Dice, solamente levanta tu mano, háblame porque no me he ido, aquí estoy cerca.
But when I called on him, I felt like if I was dying, like if I had no.
Cuando le estaba clamando, yo me sentía como que no tenía fuerza, como que sí me estaba muriendo verdaderamente.
He says, first you trusted me.
Dice, primero confiaste en mí.
I came to trust and then you gave me belief.
Dice, yo confié que tú estabas confiando en mí y te di esa creencia.
And then after you gave me faith.
Y después te di fe.
I gave you blessing.
Yo te di bendición.
And you made a way for me.
Y tú te deciste de ellos. Como que si no venían esas bendiciones de mí. Tú me ignoraste.
But I did not ignore you.
Pero yo no te ignoré a ti. Pero tú, en tu tiempo de necesidad, tú me llamaste y aquí estoy.
I was on the side of you the whole time before you even called.
Yo estaba en un lado de tú.
Te tenía de la mano
antes de que me llamaras.
So what's the problem?
¿A cuál es el problema?
That I lost everything.
Dijo, dije, perdí todo.
My blessing,
mis bendiciones,
my trust,
mi confianza,
my faith,
mi fe,
and my belief,
y mi creencia.
He says, why'd you let it go? I said, because I can't hear you. It sounds smug.
Dice, ¿por qué lo dejaste ir? Le dije, porque no te puedo escuchar. Se oye como que no puedo entender.
I wasn't acting right. I wasn't listening.
No estaba poniendo atención.
He pulled her away.
Dios removió a ella.
He brought her to this church.
La trajo a esta iglesia.
He gave her a demand.
Le dio un mandato.
She went smoking fire home.
Se fue rápido con una lumbre.
Gathered up her family and said, "We're going back to church."
Agarró a la familia y dijo, "Vamos a regresar a la iglesia."
So I broke my yoke.
Ya que se quebró el yugo que yo traía.
I'm ready to take on.
Yo estoy listo para enfrentar.
And I'm not going to get too much further into this, but
ya no voy a seguir mucho en esto.
I wrote something down after, last night. I was like, "My mama said you want to get up there. You know you're scared."
Escribí algo y yo sé que me decía, yo sé que tienes miedo.
I was even scared to call the pastor and tell him, "Pastor, I'm scared."
Yo iba a llamar al pastor y decirle, "Pastor, yo tengo miedo."
I said, "I wait Sunday. I get there. I go to the office and tell him, Pastor, I'm scared."
And he did. Dijo, llego a la oficina, le voy a decir al pastor que tengo miedo, y sí lo hizo, llegó a mi oficina.
But thank you, Jesus, he took the fear out of me, and I didn't expect that we did this.
Gracias a Dios que me quitó el temor, y no esperé lo que sucedió esta mañana, este día.
You know, it can happen more than once, but it's still a brand new experience.
Puede suceder más de una vez, y puede ser una nueva experiencia cada vez.
And I think y'all, for the parish y'all given me and my family.
Te doy gracias a ustedes por lo que ustedes me han dado.
And the trust.
Y la confianza.
That y'all learned, that taught me to have again.
Y la confianza que ustedes me han enseñado que yo tengo otra vez.
So while I was at home.
Estaba en la casa.
I felt like I had to get in my Bible and study it all over again.
Tenía que entrar en mi Biblia y estudiar otra vez.
But while I'm sitting there, he tells me, "Think about your week."
Estaba ahí y él me dijo, "Piensa en tu semana."
What did happen here in the
week? ¿Qué es lo que sucede en nuestra semana?
I could say it's like nothing but confirmation.
Pura confirmación esta
semana. So I had labeled this "Who I am."
Y le nombré esto "¿Quién soy yo?"
With the trust of the Lord.
Con la confianza del Señor.
And just those sorts of things. Do we all know who we are?
Sabemos todos quién somos.
What we want.
¿Qué es lo que queremos?
What our heart desires.
¿Qué es lo que desea nuestro corazón?
Our reason for being.
Nuestra razón por ser.
We know each other.
Nos conocemos los unos a los otros.
Will we trust one another?
Confiaremos los unos a los otros.
And how much do we trust?
¿Y qué tanto nosotros confiamos en cada uno? En Dios.
Does it have to be that we have to be put in a situation to reveal our true selves?
Tendremos que poner, tiene que ponernos en una situación para que pueda revelar quién de veras somos nosotros.
Will we trust one another then?
¿Confiaremos en cada uno de nosotros en ese momento?
You see, Jesus trusted his people.
Jesús confió en sus discípulos, en su gente.
To do his works and good deeds.
Hacer sus obras y que él les había comentado.
Did we hold up our end?
Nosotros hicimos lo nuestro.
Even when he walked.
Aun cuando él caminó.
He trusted the people that walked beside him.
Él confió en la gente que iba caminando en su lado.
Even those he knew that would betray him.
Aun aquellos que él sabía que lo iban a traicionar.
That time has come.
Ese tiempo ha llegado.
For us to trust one another again.
Para confiar los unos a los otros otra vez.
Trust God again.
De confiar en Dios una vez más.
But how much do we believe?
¿Cuánto creemos nosotros?
And trust
y confiamos Jesús, a Jesús.
To even believe and trust one another.
De que podamos confiar en los unos a los otros.
We do it all by faith.
Lo hacemos a través de la fe.
And how do we do that?
¿Y cómo lo hacemos?
With faith, belief, and trust.
Con fe, confiando.
And I read in John 16 through 5.
En Juan capítulo 16.
Chapter
16 verse
5 through 9.
Okay. Chapter 16, capítulo 16 de Juan, del 5 al 9.
And this is Jesus speaking to his disciples.
Esto es lo que Jesús le dice a sus discípulos.
Because you know, we don't believe what we don't see.
A veces no creemos lo que no vemos.
If we've seen it, we believe it.
Si lo vemos, creemos.
If our partner's seen it, we believe it.
Si nuestra pareja lo vio,
but
lo creemos.
But if we haven't seen it, we're not convinced.
Si no lo hemos visto, a veces no lo creemos.
So he tells them, but now I go.
Dice, pero ahora te voy.
My way to him that sent me.
Del camino en el cual él me envió.
And none of you should ask me.
Y ninguno de ustedes me pregunte.
Whither goest thou?
¿Para dónde voy?
But because I've said these things unto you,
pero porque he dicho estas cosas a ti,
sorrow hath filled your heart.
El miedo ha llenado tu corazón.
Nevertheless,
pero ahora,
I tell you the truth.
Te digo la verdad.
It is expedient for you.
Es mejor para ti.
that I go away.
Que yo me vaya.
For if I go away,
porque si yo me voy,
the comfort will not come unto you.
El consolador no vendrá si no me voy.
But if I depart, I will send him unto.
Pero si yo me voy, yo te lo voy a mandar.
And he comes, will reprove the world of sin.
Y él va a reprobar al mundo de pecado.
And of righteousness.
Y de justicia.
And judgment of sin.
Y de justicia y de pecado.
Because they not believe.
Porque no creyeron.
Me.
Porque no creyeron en mí.
See, like I said, we only believe in what we see.
A veces nomás creemos lo que vemos.
We only believe in what is real right in front of us.
Y creemos en lo que es verdadero que está nomás enfrente de
nosotros. But what he left with us was a book, a word, living word.
Lo que nos dejó es un libro lleno de puras palabras de vida.
Because we all are numbered.
Porque todos estamos enumerados.
And I'm proud to be one of those numbered.
Y yo le doy gracias a uno de esos números.
And I'm proud to be one of those numbers here at this church.
Yo estoy contento con el Señor que yo soy en esta iglesia uno de esos números.
And that hopefully one day I will be that very good minister that I always wanted to be.
Y un día seré aquel ministro que yo
sé. Because I have a family of my own that I have to save out of the pit of hell.
Yo tengo una familia cual tengo que salvar de la.
That the devil, like a whale coming from up under the water, is swallowing them whole.
El diablo los está hundiendo.
Sickness.
Enfermedad.
Diseases, habits, alcoholism,
hábitos de maldición y de alcohol.
We were once a very big family.
Éramos una familia enorme, grande.
And we're down to just five.
Que ahora ya nomás tenemos cinco.
And I'm the only one to carry my name.
Y yo soy el único que carga mi nombre.
So I'm not trying to die in vain.
Yo no estoy tratando de morir.
I want to go back home, uplift my family back in church.
Quiero ir regresar a mi casa y traer a mi familia otra vez a la iglesia.
And tell them that he hasn't forgot about you like you forgot about him.
Y decirle que él no se ha olvidado de ellos como él se ha olvidado de ellos.
And for I am a reborn Christian in the spirit of God.
Y soy un cristiano nacido de nuevo.
For as he covers over me, I'm gonna cover the holiness that he's given unto me.
Y como ven, una cobertura que él tiene sobre
mí. Spiritual eyes.
Los ojos espirituales.
Spiritual ears.
Oídos espirituales.
And the spiritual tongue that he's given unto me.
Y la lengua espiritual que él me ha dado.
And all I want is just for the people that I speak unto, trust me and believe me that he walks with us now today.
Y quiero que la gente confíe que cuando le digo que él camina con nosotros, él camina con nosotros.
And that y'all are a beautiful church, and I'm glad and I'm happy to be part of y'all's family and a brother.
Aleluya. Gracias por esta iglesia tan hermosa.
Thank y'all.
But there was a young man, and I said this last week, I believe, that what he did in public, in private, God reward him in public. Que lo que él hacía en privado, see, nobody knew about the lions and the bears. Nadie sabía del león y del oso, nadie, porque él lo hizo en privado, he did it in private. Oh, but everybody knew about Goliath, pero todos sabían de Goliath. It was made publicly, fue hecho público. Pero lo que él hizo con el león y con el oso, nadie lo vio. Nobody saw what he did to the lion and to the bear. That was his practice. Esa era su práctica con el oso y con el león. That's why when he saw the giant, por eso cuando miró el gigante, dijo, man, this is nothing. I mean, I knocked down animals worse than this one. He derribado gigantes peores que este. Este no es nada para mí. And I told you this. And I wrote this on Facebook, I believe it was this week. Who says to Facebook? David never called Goliath a giant. He called him an uncircumcised Philistine. Dios nunca dijo, David nunca dijo que Goliath era un gigante. Él le dijo, ¿quién es este filisteo incircunciso que está atacando el pueblo de Dios? He never saw him as a giant. He saw him just like anybody else. Nunca lo vio como un gigante, lo vio como cualquier otra persona. That's why he looked at him and said, today, I'm going to kill you. And he said, listen close to me, Goliath. Dijo, mira, escúchame bien, Goliath. Esta noche, este día, te voy a matar.
Hallelujah.
And he said, I'm going to kill you and I'm going to chop your head off with your sword.
Amen.
Dijo, con tu propia espada, dijo, te voy a cortar la cabeza. Con tu propia. In other words, I don't have a sword, I just have a sling. Nomás tengo una onda, agarra la onda. Agarra la onda, hermano, agarra la onda, ¿ves? David no traía espada. You don't get it when you go home. Usted la agarra cuando va a la casa, usted la va a agarrar. Agarra la onda, amén. David didn't have a sword. David no traía espada. Pero le dijo a Goliat, Goliat, con tu propia arma. In other words, what you're using against me, I'm going to turn it around and use it against you. Lo que tú vas a hacer en contra de mí, yo lo voy a voltear y lo voy a usar en contra de ti. My God. See, you need to turn the tables around on the enemy. Usted tiene que voltearle la mesa al enemigo, decir, todo lo que tú estás trayendo contra mí, yo lo voy a devolver y lo voy a echar contra ti. Aleluya. My God, can I get an amen, somebody? I want you to lift up your hands right there where you are. Levanta tus manos ahí donde estás. And I want you to confess this with me. Quiero que confieses esto conmigo. I want you to say, from this day forth, desde este día en adelante, I will no longer walk in fear. Ya no caminaré en temor. But I will walk by faith. Caminaré por fe. And I will accomplish. Y yo llevaré a cabo everything. Todo. Everything. 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 La palabra favorita de mi hermana Flores. Everything. Everyday. Every day. Not just Monday. Not just Sunday. No más el domingo o el lunes. No, no, no. Todos los días.
Aleluya.
I will walk in victory. Caminaré en victoria. Along with my household. Con mi casa.
As for me and my house,
we will serve the Lord. Mi casa y yo serviremos a Jehová. Dígame a alguien, aleluya. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, somebody give God praise for this. Do not walk in fear any longer. Fear is disobedience. El miedo, el temor es desobediencia. Camine en fe, walk in faith. Listen, if he said it, then what you waiting for? Right? Si Dios lo dijo, ¿para qué es lo que está esperando? What are you waiting for? If God already told you to possess the land, possess the land. He gave you everything you need to possess the land. He won't tell you to possess the land if he hasn't equipped you. God will equip the called. He doesn't call the equipped. He equips the called. Dios no llama al equipado, Dios equipa al llamado. That's a tweetable moment right there. Tweetable moment. You're right, Pastor Richard? Oh, okay. I'm just you're helping me, thank you. I love that. My wife always helps me. But listen, walk in fear or walk in faith. Walk in fear or walk in faith. Camina en temor en miedo o camina en fe. You can either be blessed through faith or be tormented by fear. Puede ser bendecido por fe o puede ser tormentado por ese temor. Pero de hoy en adelante somos libres de ese temor. Today we are free from fear. Say amen, somebody. Give God praise right now. I'm done.
Thank you, Jesus.
Let me tell you something. Real quick. My brother, John, is going to share a little bit with you of what God has been doing in his life. He's going to share a little bit with you, and then Sister Jessica is going to come and do the final announcements. Hermana Jessica vendrá con los últimos anuncios. I'm going to ask my brother John to come here, and as he shares with you a little bit of what God has done in his life. We have to give you a clap. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Number two.
Jesus, everybody.
Que lo bendiga.
For those who don't know me, my name is John Archie Collins. I can give a full name. It's very long. I got nicknames for everything.
Mi nombre es John Collins.
And I wrote something getting ready for, you know, because I called pastor. I was sitting down. I don't know if anybody ever watched the movie Life of Pi. It's a Disney movie.
Hay una película en Disney. Go ahead.
When they first showed the preview, they said nothing about religion.
Cuando enseñaron los cortos de esta película, no dijeron nada de religión.
If y'all don't know, I feel that Jesus is everything. God is everything around us. Any movement, anything that on earth, God has something to do with. That's what he'll give you a message.
Jesús, Dios está en todo, porque ahí es donde Dios toma la oportunidad para darnos el mensaje.
Now this movie's been out for 3 years, and I've been telling my wife, I want to see that movie. No reason why, it just looked good. I like this movie.
Quería ver, yo le dije a mi esposa, ya por 3 años, yo quiero ver esta película, no hay ninguna razón, nomás le dije que quería ver esta película.
So finally when I got to see it,
cuando la vi por primera vez,
the subliminal message in it that I thought that probably might even the people who made the movie even got it.
El mensaje sublime de esa película que aún yo pienso que la gente que creó la película ni lo agarraron.
Did another thing in my life that had been doing all that week. It was another confirmation that God was speaking to me.
A través de eso era una confirmación de que Dios estaba hablando a mi vida a través de esa semana.
And I sat in that back when I first got here. I sat in that back, and I'm sure Pastor Rachel and Tim, they see me moving, twitching.
Cuando llegué, yo me senté atrás y los pastores me miraban que yo me movía por un lado para otro.
Brother Anthony ready to catch me at the door.
El hermano Anthony estaba listo para pescarme ahí en la puerta.
But I was fighting with my battle.
Yo estaba batallando, yo estaba peleando con algo.
Now I'm from a family that my grandfather is a preacher.
Yo vengo de una familia donde mi abuelito es un predicador.
Christian.
Un cristiano.
So I'm a know better.
Yo soy una persona que sabe mejor que eso.
I know the things that I should be being as a Christian.
Yo sé las cosas que yo debo de ser siendo cristiano.
But I got lost during one of my battles of trying to step and be like a Christian.
Y tratando yo de vivir como cristiano, me perdí y me salí de los caminos del Señor.
So, the love of my wife.
Con el amor de mi esposa.
Kept me in the seat, which is my most private one back.
Me mantuve en el asiento sin moverme, aun cuando me estaba moviendo, sin salirme, me mantuve ahí.
Because we've been having problems in our home, and like I said, the enemy catches you at any weakest point in your life.
El enemigo, estamos teniendo problemas en mi casa, pero el enemigo viene y te pesca en los momentos más débiles de tu vida.
So, when I met this church, when I started coming to this church, I would come in and go right back out. I wouldn't say hi to them.
Cuando yo llegué a esta iglesia, yo venía y me iba y no saludaba a nadie.
But I grew in this church.
Pero crecí en esta iglesia.
And y'all became more than just civilians, people. Y'all became my family.
Ustedes vinieron a ser mi familia, no solamente gente, pero mi familia.
I don't come to church, they call to check on.
Cuando no vengo a la iglesia, ellos llaman para chequear a ver cómo estoy.
When one of mine are sick, y'all call to check on.
Cuando uno de los míos está enfermo, ustedes hablan para saber a ver cómo están ellos.
Y ustedes me enseñaron cómo confiar. So, when I told Pastor Tim that I wanted to testify, it's because I wanted to get over a fear of being shy, being shameful. I was ashamed to think God himself.
Cuando él me habló a mí, él solamente quería testificar y decirles que él quería salir de esa timidez. Él tenía miedo de eso.
And I was rebellious. I didn't want to listen.
Yo era rebelde, yo no quería escuchar nada.
And then he put me in a time of insomnia.
Y me puso en un tiempo de insomnia. No podía dormir en las noches. Y es cuando el enemigo trata de lo más es en la noche.
The only light I had was the TV, and his bad to sleep the TV on after night.
La única luz que tenía era la televisión y era peligroso dormir.
So the battle was on.
Y la batalla era constante.
I knew how to pray, and it's crazy because you know something, it becomes a habit, and you forget it all.
Yo sabía cómo orar.
Out of fear.
Y por el temor se me olvidó cómo hacer cosas. O orar.
So to get on my knees to pray was the hardest thing. That was the biggest
Doblar rodilla y orar era uno de los más grandes temores que yo tenía, miedo que el enemigo había puesto en mi corazón.
But it wasn't the prayer that was fearing me. It was the, if I got on my knees to pray, the enemy was going to fight harder.
Yo, mi temor no era la oración, mi temor era que si yo doblaba rodilla, el enemigo me iba a atacar más duro.
So, I finally hit my knees and I said, Jesus, why?
Y yo caí de rodillas y le dije, Jesús, ¿por qué?
Why do you keep talking to me when you know I can't hear you?
¿Cuándo, si, ¿por qué sigues hablándome a mí si sabes que yo no te puedo escuchar?
Why do you keep talking to me when you know I'm not going to listen?
¿Por qué me sigues hablando si tú sabes bien que yo no te voy a poner atención, no te voy a hacer caso?
He said, you called me.
Dijo, tú me llamaste a mí.
And I come to set me for you.
Dijo, y yo vengo aquí porque tú dijiste.
I called you 3 years ago when I was laying in my, you know, bed sick.
Yo te llamé, le dijo él a Dios. Yo te llamé hace 3 años cuando yo estaba en una cama enfermo.
The doctors called me and told me I had cancer and I was gonna. There was nothing they could do for me.
Los doctores dijeron que yo tenía cáncer y no podían hacer ya nada por mí.
I was weighing 98 pounds.
Yo pesaba 98 libras.
I was being tormented and I would cry his name, not for him to help me, but for him to take me.
Yo estaba siendo atormentado y yo ya clamaba a Dios no para que me sanara, sino para que solamente me llevara.
My uncle was in the ministry and I called on him. I said, I can't do it by myself. I can't do it. He says, I can't do it either.
Yo le llamé a uno de mis tíos que es un ministro. Le dije, ya no puedo hacerlo solo. Ayúdame. Y él dijo, yo tampoco puedo hacerlo.
So he left me with 2 chapters, with 2 books. It was Colossians 1.
Me dejó con solamente unos versículos, Colosenses 1 y Colosenses 2.
And my wife, we didn't study anything, we were newbies.
Nosotros éramos nuevos, no estudiamos.
Yeah, what do I do?
Ella agarró el libro y dijo, ¿qué hago? Y él dijo, empieza a leer.
And then when she did, I think that's one of our darkest moments.
Eso, lo que ella hizo, fue uno de los momentos más oscuros.
She helped save me.
Ella ayudó para que yo fuera salvo.
She was reciting and praying like she was a Christian, an elder.
Ella empezó a orar y empezó a recitar la Biblia como si ella fuera una anciana en la iglesia.
She brought that demon about me.
Ella, ese demonio que yo tenía, ella lo sacó de fuera.
I can't thank her enough for doing that.
Y no puedo darle la gracia lo suficiente por hacer
not
eso.
Not only God stayed by my side, he gave her the strength.
No solamente Dios se mantuvo en mi lado, pero Dios le dio la fuerza a ella, que ella también se mantuviera de mi lado.
So I got better.
Me mejoré.
Gave me my job.
Me dio mi trabajo.
I was supporting family.
Estaba soportando mi, apoyando a mi familia otra vez.
We were going to the Catholic church.
Estábamos yendo a la iglesia católica.
I wasn't fulfilling me because I was hungry.
No me estaba llenando porque yo tenía hambre.
And so I was sitting at home and watching Charles Stanley on TV.
Me quedaba en la casa viendo televisión a un predicador, Charles Stanley. Estaba mucho, había mucho static en la televisión y movía la antena para un lado y otro. Y no era la televisión, sino que era yo mismo el que estaba haciendo el programa.
The last thing I heard on TV from Charles Stanley was, can you, as being a Christian, get lost in your sin?
Como cristiano, la última cosa que escuché fue, tú puedes como cristiano perderte otra vez en el pecado.
And the battle was on.
Y el pecado y la guerra estaba ahí contigo otra vez.
We got lost, we got off track, we stopped praying. Right there in our home, and that's what church is, starts in your house.
Perdimos otra vez la comunicación con Dios, nos perdimos otra vez y dejamos de adorar y alabar a Dios en nuestra casa. Y ahí es donde comienza la adoración, en tu casa.
I even had my kids sitting down reading.
Yo tenía a mis hijos también leyendo conmigo las escrituras.
We all got off track, all because